So 23 is Edge. I want to take this time to focus on some of the games that try to go for a more dramatic realism approach with their combat that I've covered in the past but haven't really delved into. Now, of course, the first one that's going to come to mind for a lot of people is Rollmaster. What with the infamous critical tables that it has. But there's a couple others that I do want to focus on. Now, the first of which being Riddle of Steel, which I haven't covered, but I have covered two of its successors. Riddle of Steel had the blessing of the Renaissance Martial Arts Association and was a very interesting approach for its time, given the fact that it was trying to go with this set of maneuvers where there was not just basic attack, but you had different angles, different ways to approach, different stances that could be used with different weapons by default. And I always like that kind of thing because combat is a dance in one form or another. And it's just that this is a dance that ends with one person bleeding out on the floor. It was the combination of really Rollmaster through MURP and Riddle of Steel that opened my eyes to how interesting you can make combat that doesn't involve mages casting some sort of auto win. And that's always why, whenever I come back to D&D, I end up being frustrated that if I want to play a pure fighter, I end up getting hampered. And then the only time I wasn't hampered was when I either house ruled the crap out of it, introduced a bunch of third party books, or used the one edition that everybody hates but me. This is also why I vehemently disagree with John Wick's assertion that weapon tables aren't needed, because what he may be looking at with those sort of things is weapon tables not really being used effectively. When you're introducing different damage types, damage areas, and the like, and the game being a way to work around advantages and disadvantages, then the type of weapon that one carries is going to be interesting. And beyond that, the type of weapon that somebody picks can be as much of an indicator of characterization as anything else. Say, for instance, Cole using an axe, even though everybody around him is using swords, and axes are seen as just a tool for chopping wood. That's just one example, but the point is that don't sleep on melee combat. And don't sleep on melee combat detail, even if you want to claim that your game is more about the story. You can have good stories through a duel. Hell, it's been done before in film.